Hey everyone, my name is Will Valida. I'm a software engineer and cloud architect. And in this video, we're going to take a look at how we can use GitHub Copilot in Azure Data Studio. Now we can use a GitHub Copilot in Azure Data Studio in two ways. We can type code in the editor and GitHub Copilot will provide suggestions to us in real time. We can also type a natural language comment, which then GitHub Copilot will use to provide suggestions for code that kind of corresponds to what we want to generate in the comment. Now, GitHub Copilot chat isn't currently available for Azure Data Studio, but what we can do with Azure Data Studio is we can install the GitHub Copilot extension. And this will essentially enable GitHub Copilot to work alongside us within Azure Data Studio. Now to use this, you need version 1.44 or later, and obviously a GitHub Copilot subscription. So what I've got, if I go back into my connections, I've got a simple AdventureWorks 2022 database. This is the light version, and I'll put a link in the comment to where you can actually get a backup file to that and actually how you can restore that so you can test this out yourself. But I've got a query here, or just an open file here, where I'm going to start writing some queries. So with Copilot, when we start to write T-SQL queries within our editor, GitHub Copilot can provide suggestions for common T-SQL syntax. So let's take an example. Say if I'm looking to just have a look at what's inside the product table, I'm just going to go... sales LT product, and if I go, okay, the name, product number, list price, we can see that GitHub Copilot is starting to select this for, to suggest this for me. So if I generate that, that looks pretty good. Let's do something a little bit more elaborate. I'm actually going to do an inner join on sales LT product category. And if I type on, let's see what it does there. So it looks like there's a product category column in that product table. So I'm going to go ahead and do that. It's also suggested a where clause as well. It's giving me a little bit of issues on the name property. So if I go ahead, just delete that. If I just try and look for name again, still getting a bit of an issue. So if I go product.name, it likes that. Yeah, because I'll need to add an alias to it. So if I go ahead and just run that, there's no results. If I remove that where clause, what's going to happen there? And there we go. I'm starting to get that back. What if I go sales LT, product category name as category name? There we go. Just run that. There we go. I'm starting to get category names for my products. So there we go. Copilot is actually working to provide suggestions for common T-SQL syntax as I'm typing. But really, another cool thing that we can do is actually get generated T-SQL code through comments that we make in our editor. So let me try this. So I'm going to say select the name. Let's have actually a look at the table. So if I'm going to use that product table again, and let's have a look at the columns. So I can see I've got columns for name, product number, color, list price, size, weight, product category ID. Okay, so let's write a comment. So what I want to select the name, the color, list price, size, weight, the product category name from the sales LT product table. So you get Copilot is actually suggesting how I'm going to get these columns from the different tables. So it suggested the product table and the product category table. So if I press enter, let's have a look. So it suggested another comment, which is not ideal. So what I can do with GitHub Copilot, there are two things that I can do. I can see alternative suggestions by looking at alt and then left-hand bracket. And there we go. I'm starting to see some other suggestions that GitHub Copilot is suggesting. So I can alternate between them using the left or right hand bracket while holding the Alt key down. So if I go ahead and just enter that, I'm going to select that from my product table. Hopefully it will show the join as well. So if I go ahead and run that, oh, there is a bit of a issue there. Yep, I need to add the on condition there. And there we go. There's my table again. But if I go ahead and delete that, and as I'm alternating through these different suggestions, if I don't like that, again, it's disregarded the SQL query for me now. What I can do is press Control Enter. If you've watched my previous videos on using GitHub Copilot in Visual Studio Code, it's very similar. It's the same command. And there we go. So GitHub Copilot is suggesting or giving me more suggestions now. So there's some SQL queries. So that's the SQL query that is suggested to me before. And it looks fairly similar. So here are a whole bunch of suggestions. Let's just pick one at random. If I pick the first one, run that, that looks pretty good. I'll generate some more. What I'll do is actually delete my SQL code that it suggested to me. Get rid of that. Press Control Enter again. And let's have a look at suggestion two. And there we go. So as you can see, we can use GitHub Copilot to either suggest code as we're, or suggest SQL code as we're typing it, or we can write some comments and then GitHub Copilot can either suggest some SQL code to us within our editor, or we can press Control Enter and get a whole bunch of suggestions from GitHub Copilot, which is pretty cool. Now, GitHub Copilot works with IntelliSense inside Azure Data Studio to provide suggestions for code completions. IntelliSense is a feature that Azure Data Studio provides anyway, and it provides suggestions for code completion, parameter information, and object names. And it's enabled by default in Azure Data Studio. So what we can do with IntelliSense code snippets and GitHub Copilot. So IntelliSense is the feature that I talked about earlier. Code snippets are just essentially mini T-SQL code templates that are inbuilt or custom made. And what we can do to actually kind of toggle these on and off, press Control and then comma. And if I start to type IntelliSense here, I can see that these are enabled. So if I want to disable these, I can just go ahead and unclick these. And if I go down, there's suggestions as well. I can actually go ahead and disable these if I want to. So with GitHub Copilot and working alongside IntelliSense, they kind of almost complement each other. But if you want to turn off IntelliSense and just rely on GitHub Copilot, you can go ahead and do that. So that wraps up this video on how to use GitHub Copilot within Azure Data Studio. If you like this video, give it a like. If you have any questions, please pop them in the comment section below. And as always, if you want to see more video on GitHub Copilot, Azure, AI, or programming in general, don't forget to subscribe. No matter where you are in the world, I hope you're having a great day, and we'll see you all next time.